name of the chapter is finding area by definite integral. Let's say y is equal to fx, one function is there. This function may be any type. See, one line I have drawn, this curved line. This is the worst kind of curve. It can be any kind. This is one line parallel to y-axis, x equal to a. Another line parallel to y-axis, that is x equal to b. Here also I have written the function, the line, and x-axis. So 1, 2, 3, and this curve. So these four lines, two are straight line, three are straight line, and one curved lines. So area bounded by these four lines, the formula will be a to b fx dx, or fx means y, y dx. Why a to b? Here you see x equal to a, y equal to b, that is why a to b. And y dx, y equal to the function, so y dx. So in place of y, if you put the function, then area will be a to b fx dx. Now here reference axis is taken x axis. Now if we do not take x axis, if we take y axis, then what will happen? Let us see that. Here you see the same thing, x equal to fy. The last one is y equal to fx. This one is x equal to fy. And the line, this one is parallel to x axis, that is y equal to a. This one that is parallel to x axis, that is y equal to b, I consider. And y axis means this one. And the function, this one. So area bounded by these four lines. Three are straight lines and one is curved line. So the area formula will be a to b x dy. That one was y dx, this one will be x dy. So these two are the formula of this exercise. That's all.